What's up, guys? It's the 15th. It's November. It's 2024. This is the second time I'm making this video because the first time, for some reason, my audio didn't work at all. So here we go. I have talked to a whole bunch of people that live in the area in Michigan, two people that work at the airport in Michigan, and three people that are actively doing search and rescue down in Asheville, North Carolina. I've spoken to these people. These aren't videos that I've seen, etc., blah, blah, blah. There are no FEMA trucks at the airport in Michigan yet. This is what I got. Richie, been a sub for a long time. Nothing is on site currently, but we'll share when it does happen. Local citizens have been wondering the same question as you and your followers have about this topic. Our representatives made a statement today, blah, blah, blah. I don't care. All I wanted to know is, are they there as of yet, right now? And no, they're not. But here's what's going on at the FEMA camp that they say doesn't exist down in North Carolina.
Can't tell you.
Can't tell me, or you don't know?
Can't tell you.
Because they're saying they're FEMA, and they're not.
Okay. Have you called your local law enforcement?
No, we called Washington, D.C., and FEMA said, no, we don't have a site there.
Because we'll never tell you where we are.
Policemen run up on our people and talk to them crazy. We've had people jump out with machine guns and AKs and machetes and handguns and all types of stuff. So we're jumpy as hell right now.
Oh, I get it. I believe it. Well, nobody here, to my knowledge,
we've been good at Henderson.
Wants to hurt you.
Yeah, we've been good at Henderson.
It's up in the mountains where people want to stay alone, leave us alone. We don't need your help.
We've been up there, too.
I was trying to clear things up.
Yeah.
Because for one, your safety and ours
is important.
Is reflected on what's happening somewhere where they're saying they're doing something, and if they're not really doing that, then that affects us and you.
Excellent way to find out if you got a legitimate federal employee. Say, hey, can I take a picture of your badge? Watch that person step out.
Right. That's the thing. This is multiple times this same facility. With other people?
We have problems at that facility where people were going in, they had on body cams, they had fake uniforms on FEMA, and they were going through asking questions and walking through. So the reason why is because the security already had to deal with that in the security suite. So they're very alert, extremely alert. A lot of those guys come out of correctional office, probably correctional jails,
right.
Facilities and federal facilities. So they're jumpy as hell, and they're looking for a reason to find somebody out. They want that.
You see what he says here? Correctional officers, federal facilities, they're jumpy as hell. They're looking for a reason to box somebody up. They want that body. They want to kill somebody. This is from JWTV. Somebody sent me this footage earlier, but it's easier where I'm at in my current studio to steal his video. JWTV, he drives around in a van and makes videos, whatever. But this is the FEMA facility in North Carolina, and it's massive, and it looks exactly what was described that's going to be at the airport in Michigan. And I know the reason why. I know the exact reason why. This makes complete military sense. You see this? There's no homeless people. There's no people that were being rescued from the waters. There's no homeless children here. You know what I mean? They're not helping people here. They're staging. They're staging here, which, well, I'll explain it to you. They're staging here, and then they're going to stage here. Michigan is up here in the slight damage or green zone. And down here in North Carolina is also the green zone. They're going to set off the New Madrid fault line. I said this about a month or so ago when the rain started. I said, these guys are purposefully flooding out the entire New Madrid fault line. They're oversaturating the land with water. And they've been doing drills there four times this year, 2024. The Army Corps of Engineers has done drills there. They're drilling there because they're going to set it off. And they're going to set it off because of many things. It'll kill a lot of people. They're not there to help people. They're not staging ahead of time because they know an earthquake is coming. It doesn't work like that. They're going to set it off. And maybe this will help you make more sense out of it. Check this out.
But we're going to take whatever we have and head out to the second safest state, second or first safest state in the United States when it comes to disasters. Now, I know I keep saying that, but that's very important. But how would they know that the New Madrid fault line is ready to go in a very big way? Well, you see, they, like I said, they have been running constant drills on this fault line as of 2024, more than they've ever done in previous years. And FEMA has actually been crunching the numbers. They've been crunching the totals of how much everything would cost, the disasters, the people that would lose their lives, and so forth. The University of Kentucky created a 57-page PDF that calculates and tells us everything that would occur if an 8.0 or greater earthquake were to strike the New Madrid fault line. And I'll go ahead and pin that in the comment section below and also pin that in the description of this video. That PDF will be very, very important. So what is the goal here? What is the agenda? Why do certain organizations know that this fault line is going to go well in advance? Well, let's go ahead and take a look at something. This simulation, and like I said, there's been a lot of simulations in 2024 on the New Madrid fault line, computer and physical simulations. But let's take a look at this computer simulation created by the USGS on April 4th, 2024. Taking a look at the simulation, you can see the earthquake starting in Blytheville. And as the earthquake starts to spread out, the heaviness of this earthquake, the intensity of the earthquake starts to fade away, heading in multiple locations. But the brunt of this earthquake, the intensity of this earthquake, the intensity heads directly to Little Rock, Arkansas, South Arkansas. Now, isn't it rather interesting that a month ago, news broke out letting us all know that Arkansas was a giant hidden source of lithium. Matter of fact, Arkansas has the world's most lithium. Looking at this map, this is where the world's most lithium is located. And looking at the USGS simulation of this earthquake, well, again, this is where the intensity of this earthquake will be heading. Is this a coincidence? I don't know. Well, here is a rather interesting article by the USGS, the same USGS that gave us this very interesting simulation. This article was published on October 21st, 2024, a little less than a month ago. It is titled, Unlocking Arkansas Hidden Treasure. USGS uses machine learning to show large lithium potential in the Smackover Formation. The Smackover Formation, again, is located in South Arkansas. Reading from the article, it says, using a combination of water testing and machine learning, a United States Geological Survey-led study estimated between 5 and 19 million tons of lithium reserves are located beneath southwestern Arkansas. If commercially recoverable, the amount of lithium present would meet projected 2030 world demand for lithium in car batteries nine times over.
Okay, because of my limited studio right here, you're going to have to look up the Army Corps of Engineers doing four separate drills on the New Madrid fault line this year alone. The Army doesn't do that. They'll do a drill. You get one. That's it. They're doing this drill while they should be over in Asheville recovering people, but they're not going to recover people. I spoke to somebody who's been doing search and rescue, real search and rescue in Asheville the entire time. They've got over 10,000 bodies. The mainstream doesn't even talk about it anymore, and they left us off with a number of 200. 10,000 people got murdered. Standing there, and all of a sudden a wall of water just washes them away in front of them. I mean, it's horrific. It's heart-wrenching. And they're going to do this to a massive area, and they're going to do this soon because, A, they're staging FEMA. There'll be another state over here in the green zone that we won't hear about because the guy that works at the airport up in Michigan spilled the beans. How do we know that? Because he was giving a press conference. He was just talking matter of fact. No big deal. Yeah, FEMA's coming here. They're taking over the building. We got to move someplace else. Well, they're going to be above, all the way around it. And the other thing about this is the solar eclipse. Remember the solar eclipse that I drove from California all the way to the exact epicenter to film? Because they're like, you got to see this, you got to see this. And then I find out after the fact that A, 4 days before the eclipse, NASA said, oh, we have a spacecraft. We can now create solar eclipses whenever we want. And then while I'm there, I literally found out there was no moon. And then a bunch of people found it out. There was no moon. So what was all that? What was the eclipse crossing over this exact area? And now all of a sudden they cannot stop absolutely oversaturating the land that they're simultaneously doing drills on, that they're coincidentally staging all the way around. They're going to do this, and they're going to do it soon because they've got the land prepared and they're prepping. They're preparing. They're not preparing for you. You heard the dude. You heard the FEMA supervisor. All the people we've got here at the FEMA campground, they're just looking to put somebody in a box. They're looking to body somebody. What? You know what I'm saying? But this is where we live. Agenda 2030 has sped up. These guys are ahead of course right now. And Trump is at the lead. Trump is without a doubt in on it. I mean, come on. Whether he's a useful idiot, they're going to put a hole in him. But Trump brought you Operation Warp Speed. Trump didn't mention the DOD directive. September 27th, 2024, troops can fire on American citizens. Is it because they're going to do this and nuke this entire area? Absolutely. This is a new map. FEMA basically just put this out. You see what I'm saying? But listen to this.
We get that, 2030. And we do know that the United Nations has a 2030 agenda that they are really pushing. And we know that they are expediting the 2030 agenda because the World Economic Forum and the United Nations met in September of 2024 to speed up the 2030 agenda. But make no mistake about it, this lithium is not just for car batteries, electric car batteries. It's also for these smart cities. It's for these robots. It's for a lot of other technology that will be pushed on us. And they really need it for their 2030 agenda. They need a lot of it. So we have the same USGS finding anywhere between 5 and 19 million tons of lithium that will help supply the world nine times over to help push along this 2030 agenda, while at the same time, they are saying this exact location, they are projecting to take the brunt of the New Madrid earthquake. You can't make it up. You cannot make this up even if you wanted to. And at the same time, you have FEMA, get what I'm saying? FEMA, located in a state perfectly nestled in a spot to where they can roll out to these states that were affected by the New Madrid earthquakes.
Now FEMA is positioning themselves all the way around the New Madrid fault line, and it isn't to help you. It isn't to help you. You've already seen all the military trucks. You see what's going on. You have to. If you live in this area, revert back to what I've been telling you for the last 15 years and prepare yourselves. Prepare yourselves in every way you possibly can, but the most important way possible, the most important thing you can do is prepare yourself spiritually. I cannot stress that enough. And when I say that, I'm living it, okay? You're never gonna see me in a million years read a book that's 500 and something pages long when I can simply read an audiobook. And there is zero monetary gain to me, because I'm doing this because it's the right thing to do, and I'm reading the book, and the author isn't making one single cent off it. Everything goes to Rob Skiba's widow, period. This is a good addition to have next to your Bible, because hell is coming. They are going to open up hell. They said they used machine learning, which means AI. They figured out a way to fake the world into seeing a solar eclipse that didn't exist because there was no moon. This is all above our pay grade. This is spiritual stuff going on right now. But some of us can actually see what's going on. Some of us are doing it for complete shock value. Some of us are doing it because there's too many people in this world that are good people that don't deserve what's coming. This is my way of making up for the first half of my life now. Dead serious. Be ready. You've been warned. My studio time's up. I'm out.